Hey guys, so today I'm gonna show you guys how to open up a pomegranate. But first, let me let you know some facts about pomegranates and let me tell you why they're my favorite fruit up to date today. Firstly, it has a lot of health benefits. It's rich in fiber, vitamins, minerals, and it even has some proteins. Like how much better can it get than that, all in one? It's also, you know, very supportive of your digestive system. What else can I tell you? Oh, it's rich in antioxidants and anti-inflammatory compounds, which is always great. You know, just to name a few benefits, but I personally love, like, all of that stuff is a plus, but I personally love pomegranates because, you know, they're juicy, sweet, and just so tasty. So let's check it out. In order to cut this beautiful pomegranate up, you want to get yourself, you know, a handy dandy paring knife, and you just kind of, you know, want to open it up on top like a circle, okay, just like this. Circle around the top. See my little incision? All right, and then what you want to do is peel it off. Peel off the top. I already have some seeds coming out. Another fun fact, the seeds inside, you know, inside the actual pomegranate, they're called arrows. I learned that today. Just to share that with you guys. All right. So this is what it looks like from up top. So the next part is, so you guys see, it has some white flesh inside. So as you can see, it has the flesh as barriers, and you know, you can see the little segments, right? So it's about, you know, 4 or 5 segments around there, I'm roughly estimating. So what you wanna do is you wanna cut along where you see those segments, you wanna cut along downward to the bottom, right? For each segment, okay, as so. Right, like this. The next segment right here. Get a little messy, like it's already juicy, the juices are flowing, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, just make sure you're doing it, you know, on a surface that it's okay to get messy on. All right, so we're gonna go around the pomegranate, and you can see how I cut down, just followed along, you know, the flesh guidelines inside. So what's next is, so I got my bowl. You just kind of want to separate it like this, right? You could see the flesh. The flesh is very bitter. You don't want to eat it. So FYI. So you see the bowl is already catching some of the looser seeds inside. Everywhere. Okay, so this is my pomegranate. You know, it looks like a nice little flower. And after this, guys, you see how easy it was? Basically, like 2 steps, the top and then the segments on the sides, you know what I'm saying, following the white flesh, and then boom, you got your pomegranate open. The next step is pretty simple. You can either go in with a spoon, and you know, I've seen people literally like just hit it so the seeds could come off. You know, you could scoop it with the spoon, but me personally, I kind of like to get a little hands-on. So this is my way of, my method of doing it. I just kind of, you know, rip some segments apart so it's less messy and I could have both hands available. I just kind of literally just take the seeds off with my hands. I personally just like this method. I find it to be very easy. Yeah, do it hands-on because, you know, you just kind of have more control of what goes into your bowl. Like I said, the white flesh is not, you know, nothing will happen if you eat it, but it doesn't taste good. It's bitter. So, you know, you just don't want to go for that part. So, yeah. And then you just go through each section so you get all your seeds out. Using my method though, you know, like I said, it could get messy, it could get juicy, you know, the juice might squirt in different directions, so it could get on your clothes, you know what I'm saying? So you care about the shirt you're wearing, I just would be careful. That's the word I was looking for. Using your hands is you have more of a chance of containing the mess. There you go. And you know, even along the way, pop some seeds in your mouth, get a little taste. You can see how rewarding all this work takes. Cause you know, eating a pomegranate, you have to put some work to get into the good juicy parts, you know what I'm saying? So once everything's out and you eat it in a bowl, like, it's just so fulfilling. Sometimes, you know, the pomegranate might have like a few bad seeds. I don't bother with those. This is how my bowl is looking so far. So far, so good. As you can see, I've already spotted some white flesh. So, you know, it's not as bad. It's a quick, easy fix. You could just, you know, pull it out and it's all good. Last part. They go everywhere. Oh, you see, perfect example. It's okay, I'm okay with that though. Almost done. So this is the aftermath. This is the flesh, the final result. And this is my beautiful product of my hard work. As you can see, the least minimal amount of white flesh got into my bowl. And that's an easy fix. You just pick it all out with my hand picking method. Look at how beautiful that looks. That nice, beautiful, fluorescent, dark red, you know what I'm saying? Just so juicy. I love it! Time for the final verdict. This is where I use my phone. All right, ready? Just how I imagined it. Fulfilled all expectations. I can literally eat this all day. The way the seeds just burst in your mouth, nothing like it. For me, 10 out of 10. Cheers. Another quick thing to mention about pomegranates is they're in season through October to January. So that's the best time to buy your pomegranates and they'll be great and fruitful. Thank you.